Now, yes, we know that correlation is a relationship between two variables. Let's perform an exercise. I try to find out, does there some relationship exist between the two variables x and y? What are these two variables? X is advertisement expenditure and y is sales. Generally, as we said, that this is in habit of taking y as an dependent variable, and x we generally take as an independent variable. Dependent and independent variable, again, let us brush up what was it. The variable that depends on the other variable for its value. For example, if I say y is a function of x. Now, x is independent variable. And this y depend upon x. So, I would say this is a dependent variable. Now, one more example. If I say x is 2. And if I have defined y in terms of x like a plus bx, where a and b have given you like this. Look at this equation. What is this equation? This equation says for a different values of x, you will get different values of y. So y depend upon x. What is the value of x? Then only we can calculate the value of y. So y is dependent and x will be called independent variable. Like here I would say expenditure, expenses. What are the expenses? X expenses ko show karta hai, to y sales ko show karai. Jitna kharcha badhate jayenge kisi pe, advertisement pe, promotions pe, to utni sales aapki badhti jayegi. To sales depend karegi kitna kharcha kar rahe hain aap. एडवर्टाइजमेंट में कितना कर रहे हैं, प्रमोशन कितना कर रहे हैं, कोई स्पेशल डिस्काउंट्स एंड ऑफर्स निकाल रहे हैं प्रमोशन के अंदर, तो डिपेंड करता है एक्सपेंसेस पर सेल्स. तो सेल्स हो गया आपका डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल, इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल हो गया आपकी एक्सपेंसेस. नाउ वन मोर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग, बिकॉज इट इज इन जनरल हैबिट दैट वाई रिप्रेजेंट डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल. वन मोर सपोर्टिंग इज लाइक व्हेन वी ड्रॉ एक्सेस and y-axis, this is depend upon x. For different values of x, I get different values of y, and this line can be plotted on the graph. Now, if I can create some relationship and I create this trend line, this can help us to find out the values. That is called predicted value. So if this equation further helps us in getting the predicted values for the future, that is, can help us in prediction. Keep this aside, concentrate on, let us come back to the numerical which we're talking about. We have taken one example, it is there. Sales and expenditures are given. This was similar to this. What they want us to find out, is there any relationship between the two variables? If there would have been no relationship, why to go further? हम उससे आगे ही क्यों बढ़े जब दो वेरिएबल में रिलेशनशिप होगी ही नहीं, तो उसके नेक्स्ट स्टेप इक्वेशन बनाना, इक्वेशन से वैल्यूज निकालने का कोई महत्व नहीं रह जाता. तो ये आगे फ्यूचर जो प्रिडिक्शन वैल्यूज है, प्रिडिक्ट निकाल करना आगे की वैल्यूज का कोई इंपॉर्टेंस नहीं है, अगर आप बेसिक दोनों वेरिएबल्स के बीच में कोई रिलेशनशिप स्टैब्लिश नहीं कर सकते. और स्टैब्लिश करते हैं तो कितनी रिलेशनशिप है, हाउ मच, पॉजिटिव है, नेगेटिव है, और क्या स्ट्रेंथ है एसोसिएशन की, दैट इज वेल कैलकुलेटेड बाय आर. तो हम पहले ही सीख चुके हैं कि आर का फॉर्मूला होता है, अब इसको हम, देयर आर डिफरेंट वेज ऑफ राइटिंग दिस फॉर्मूला, राइट. व्हाट इज स्मॉल एक्स, एक्स इज माइनस एक्स मी, स्मॉल वाई इज वाई डेटा माइनस वाई मी. रिमेम्बर दिस इज व्हाट वी हैव स्टडीड टिल अप टू दिस point. Let us apply this formula on this numerical. Expenditures are given, sales are given. Now, after so much of talk, I can say what is y in this case. I will put y as sales. So, what I would be writing sales as y. And here, expenditures was whatever the expenditure the people have given, I will write it as x. So, this x are given, y values are given. The first column is serial number. Do not get confused with serial number. They are just giving you the data of 10 different months of 10 different maths. So it has no role in the calculation. We need two variables which we want to establish the relationship. We have to find out the relationship. What is the basic first step while calculating R? Remember, step one, find out the mean of the X series, find out the mean of the Y series. Now, whenever we say mean, this data is individual series. X itself is a individual series, Y itself is a individual series. In individual series, we will calculate mean with a simple formula, which we know, sum of the values divided by number. We get the mean value. Similarly, Y mean I can calculate sum of all the Y values divided by number. Number means number of observation. In this case, we always get n number of observations same because it is always we get in pair. X and Y to hum values mil rahi hai, hume pair mein mil rahi hai. Pair mein milna matlab for 10 different months hume sales bhi mil rahi hai, for 10 different months hume expenses bhi mil rahi hai. Toh hume dono cheeze particular month ke liye mil rahi hai, so we are getting in pair. So n will be always 10. Not always, in this case n will be 10. So now let's calculate the value. Here you put you find out. So if I calculate, add all the values divided by n, that is number of observation 10, I will get 290 divided by 10. So 29 is the mean in the case of X series. In the case of Y series, I get the summation 4260. Number of observations same 10. So I get 426 mean. Step one is done. Look, calculate mean of the two data series. Step two, what I'm supposed to do now? You have to find out the difference here, which will be used in this formula. Difference of the X data from its mean, difference of the Y from its mean. So what I'm supposed to do? Find out the difference from mean. So next column would X minus X mean, that can be represented by small x. Y minus Y mean, that can be represented by small y. We'll do this exercise. Always keep in mind that to what extent this table will go. I will be needing the square of this difference, square of this difference, and one times multiplication. So in my column, I will be having three more. In this table, I will be having three more columns. Square of small x, square of y, and one multiplication. Small x into small y, x dot y, right? Once I complete this table, look at there, it's on the screen, I can find out their summation. Summation means I will be needing total of this column, total of y square small, and total of this column. Last three column ki hum summations find out. Right? Doing this calculation, what I will get, the values which is there, this summation giving me the value 2740. Check it up, it should be 27540 when you also calculate. If I get this y square summation, y square, what is small? I'm not using capital Y. There is a difference when the for the notations. Always either you use y in some books, in some somewhere you can see it's dy. Dy means difference in the y series from its mean. So maybe you can use, it's your choice, you can go for the dy also. Or instead of capital letter, in the small case, small y. So it's coming 306840. These two data, first data, second. And as I said, the addition of the third column will be required. The third column is giving me the addition of x multiplied by small y, that is deviation from the x series, deviation of the y series. The multiplication gives you the value 28310. Now just put this 1, 2, 3 into the formula and we get the value of R. So what the value of the R is coming? The value of R, if I place this 28310 divided by, make sure you don't make mistake when I got square, square root. So multiply these two values in denominator. Multiply 2740, multiplied it, and then get the square root of the product, 306840. So what calculation will yield me? And sign has to be taken care. So this is coming, column C, one is coming in positive, first is coming positive, summation of y square always will, because they are squares. This may matter. Many times it may give you negative, it may give you positive. So remain alert when this performing the exercise multiplication. So here I got positive. So I will remember that R is coming into positive. No sign has been replaced, means it is positive. So after doing this calculation, I get 976 because it is positive. So what I got? The answer is R is equal to plus 0.976. There's an importance of specifically stressing plus or minus. Why I have stressed on plus? That means there is a positive correlation between these two variables. What were these? Expenses and sales. Ye dono variables mein positive correlation hai. When I say positive correlation means dono ka jo change hai wo ek hi direction mein. Graph will come out like this. X badhega, Y badhega. तो उसका स्लोप पॉजिटिव होगा. किसका स्लोप? इन दोनों के बीच में जो इक्वेशन हम स्टैब्लिश करेंगे, जो नेक्स्ट टॉपिक रिग्रेशन में विल कवर, दैट स्लोप विल कम पॉजिटिव. सो दिस पॉजिटिव कोरिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द टू वेरिएबल सेज दैट एक्स इंक्रीजेस, वाई आल्सो इंक्रीजेस. सो जितना ज्यादा एक्सपेंसेस करोगे, जितना एक्सपेंडिचर बढ़ाओगे आप एडवर्टाइजमेंट में, उतना ही सेल्स आपकी बढ़ेगी. जो इस पर्टिकुलर केस में प्रूफ भी किया है. नाउ सेकेंड, what is this 0.976? This is the directions. Plus will give you the direction, the value, the magnitude will give you the strength of association. 0.976, 97.6% itna strong association hai. Kiske beech mein? X Y ke beech mein association ki bonding ka correlation ko show karta hai ki kitna strong association hai. Data and sign. So this is all about calculation of R in the case of the data which is given in this form, sales and expenses, and you get the value R plus 0.976. One more important thing we can get out of this value, coefficient of determination. If we remember, we talked about coefficient of determination. What was that? That is R square. What is R square? It is called coefficient of determination, which talks about what percentage of the variation is there in the sales, which is explained by this Y. So what percentage of the variation in the sales is expressed by X, that is expenses. Again, repeating it. Coefficient of determination means jo sales makes variations ho rahe, sales badh rahi hai, ghat rahi hai, उसके लिए कौन रिस्पॉन्सिबल है और कितना रिस्पॉन्सिबल है. तो उस सेल्स में जो वेरिएशन है उसके लिए रिस्पॉन्सिबल है एक फैक्टर जो हमने अभी स्टडी में लिया, वो है एडवर्टाइजमेंट की एक्सपेंडिचर. और किस परसेंटेज तक वो रिस्पॉन्सिबल है या परसेंटेज तक एक्सप्लेन करता है उस वेरिएशन को, कैन बी फाउंड आउट बाय आर स्क्वायर. व्हाट इज आर स्क्वायर? जस्ट स्क्वायर दिस, स्क्वायर ऑफ 0.976. व्हेन यू स्क्वायर द 0.976, इट विल कम समवेयर 0.95. स्क्वायर इट, the square of R will give you 0.95. 0.95 I convert it into percentage. It is 95%. Look at it. It's just great value. 95% matlab sales mein 95% tak ka jo change ho raha hai, variations ho rahe hain, usko cover karta hai, usko response, wo responsible hai kiske liye? Expenses. तो हम 95 सिर्फ कितना बचा? 5%. तो 5% वेरिएशन के लिए कोई दूसरा फैक्टर रिस्पॉन्सिबल होगा जो हमने अभी स्टडी में कंसिडर नहीं किया है. बट हमने मेजॉरिटी जो वेरिएशन है उसके लिए जो रिस्पॉन्सिबल मोस्ट प्रोमिनेंट फैक्टर है उसको हमने आइडेंटिफाई कर लिया इस केस में, और वो है एडवर्टाइजमेंट एक्सपेंडिचर. सो कोफिशियंट ऑफ कोरिलेशन गिव्स यू वन मोर इंपॉर्टेंट इंफॉर्मेशन, दैट इज कोफिशियंट ऑफ डिटर्मिनेशन, विच गिव्स यू द change variations in the dependent variable caused by the independent variable. So coefficient of determination is further an important parameter to be taken into consideration.